Hey, this is Captain Banzai. Today we're going to look at the photo editor that I use for the most part. I do still use Photoshop a little bit, my older version, CS5, but for the most part, I use mostly this Acdsee Photo Studio Ultimate 2018. There is a new version out, but I haven't bought it. I don't think I'm going to. Basically, it has the full Lightroom type capabilities plus a photo editor. Now, I use mostly the Lightroom plus the developing stuff, but besides that, it does quite a bit that I'm really not versed in. We'll potentially look at that in the future, but I'm gonna look at what I use mostly with this program. I have a few images here, different files throughout the years. You can see a nice view. You can adjust the size of them very easily. Select them, you'll get some EXIF information. You can see this one was a Pentax Star SDS, so pretty old, but I had turned this file into a DNG at some point. You can see it opens various files. That was one of the reasons that I picked up this program in the previous version, because it did open all of the files that I had at the time. The main issue I have now is that it doesn't open the files for the M50, the CR3 format. There are only a few applications that open that format, and actually with the DNG converter from Adobe, that's what I use now. It's kind of ironic and sad a little bit that I have to use Adobe software. I mean, I could potentially use Canon software and it's all right, but I've been using Adobe software to convert all of my CF3s to the DNG format so I can use them in this program. I do keep the CR3s. I'm sure eventually some version down the line it will, but I don't think 2019 is capable of that. I've adjusted this interface a little bit, but the main features are up at the top here. You can make these icons larger, the tabs if you would like, but we're in the manage screen. You've got different things like the folders, catalog, basically if you tag things, and then there's a calendar to pull files from certain time periods. You've got the preview, a little bit of information here and there. So you can easily select files, get some EXIF information. Now that's usually decent, but it feels like there's a little bit less than there should be sometimes. I don't know how all of that works, but from there you can go into different areas. With the photo tab, it takes a little bit of time usually, but this specific program has a large database format to it where any type of images you load into the program, you can basically have a record of. I don't let it index, but this program can automatically index files. So with this photo tab, it's very decent. I don't really use this too much, but you can get a year view, month view, or week view of your photos, look through them, and then you can click into each photo, dig in there. So in some ways it's very quick and helpful to use, and then you can jump into the viewer or whatever it picks. So from there, I've got this one image that I went all the way, dug all the way down into based on date, which is nice. So the photo tab, don't use it too much. With the view tab, I use it quite a bit. The nice thing about it is that it's relatively quick. You can raw decode or use the built-in previews. If you use the previews, you will not get really detailed information when you zoom in, but usually I have the raw decode enabled in that case. One nice thing about this is that you can go into a full screen mode, but you can also turn on your second screen to have a file list. So when you put the main screen in full screen, you put the other one in file list. It's very quick and convenient to go through your photos. As you can see, I'm zoomed in super close on that, but I can switch photos. It keeps where I was zoomed on the previous photo into the next photo. So that's very powerful to review images. Get out of full screen here. And then you can also do preview on the other screen if you'd like to for whatever reason. So with this, you still have some EXIF information, some zooming controls, pretty nice. Sometimes it's laggy depending on what type of files. One thing I should mention with the Fujifilm X-Trans files, I had the X100F camera for quite a while. And this program, at least with my version, is not quick. Usually they use some type of GPU acceleration with the raw files to improve speed of use, but in this case with those specific X-Trans files, it's not very quick, it's pretty laggy. Now I do experience lag in different types of files based on what they are. The main tab besides Manage that I use is this Develop tab. The thing that I don't like about it is you can't scroll and zoom and things like the other tabs, which work a lot better in that case. It's a little more clunky for getting around the file. You can see it's lagging a little bit here and there. But this has a lot of the adjustments. So if I want to boost contrast, highlights, exposure, dehaze, a lot of these here I use quite a bit. So I mean, you've got probably most of the things that you would want to have in some type of developer application. I haven't used Lightroom, so I don't know exactly what it involves, what it includes. I'm sure there's a lot to it, but in this case, this does enough of what I need to make it decent, make it worth actually paying for. So you can even put effects and things if you want to do that. These light features are very nice. So shadows, you can go into more advanced styles of adjusting the exposure and such based on different factors. I usually just use the basic feature because it handles the highlights, midtones, and shadows well enough that I don't need to go into super fine detail. And of course, white balance controls. Then we go into the detail tab inside Develop. This one you can add sharpening, noise reduction, especially on the M50, M100 cameras. I always add some noise reduction to those. One nice feature is the skin tune. I've been using that a lot on people photos for all the cosplay stuff. It definitely improves things a little bit, at least just enough that I don't necessarily need to go hardcore with the editing in that case. Geometry. Now the lens profiles in this program are not great. It's missing quite a few. You could probably make your own profiles and all that, but I haven't had any really big desire to go hard on that. And then cropping, of course, different ratios and all of that. I use that quite a bit. Some of my videos I do the 16:9 crop just because it fits better with the flow of the video and vignetting and things of that nature. And repair is one of the better features I've seen implemented in this way, because all of these develop controls are not burned into the photo. One odd thing about this program, kind of a side point, is that you have to force it to write those sidecar files. I don't think it automatically does it, at least this version that I have. So you can check a setting to have it write those sidecar files for raw files. That way all of the non-destructive edits that you've done in the develop tab are saved to a file instead of just saved to the database, because I don't trust their whole database thing. If you lose that, then all of your edits through years or whatever, you can back it up, of course, but if you lose that database or it gets corrupted, then you lose all your edits. I really just prefer the sidecar files. They're good enough in that case. But the point is, it has a repair feature that I think is relatively well implemented for what it does. It's for skin repair or whatever else. In this case, maybe if I wanted to clone out one of these rocks, to select with right click and then can potentially erase some of that. It looks decent. It's quick. Sometimes it lags, sometimes it's not great, depending on which type of raw file you're using. But in general, it seems to work well for a non-destructive repair tool, which is nice to have. With the edit tool, it is destructive. It's going to save its own file format, basically like a Photoshop file. This program can open Photoshop files. All of the ones that I've made, I haven't had issues with, so that's good. This is layered. It's similar to Photoshop. I just haven't really gotten into it. Maybe a future video we can go into detail on what this offers. It has quite a few features, but it does also kind of duplicate a lot of the stuff in the develop tab, which I don't understand why they do that, but it's there. It's an option and it does quite a bit of stuff. With the dashboard tab, this basically gives you information about what's in the database, which is pretty cool. It's really interesting to look at. It doesn't necessarily give you any real great useful information besides seeing all the photos you take and seeing which cameras and things of that nature. which, don't get me wrong, that's very interesting. So I don't know if this has pulled all my files, but you can see 2014, 24,300. A lot of these are not connected to the computer at the moment. So it has different values and information, favorite format, RAW. And we have favorite ISO setting. It's just really cool to look at rather than something extremely useful. But so we can look at the cameras I've used. Now it's not reading all of my more recent stuff. I haven't done much with those based on, you know, the database and such, but it's pretty interesting to look at. That's really it that I'm going to go over just in this basic video. I bought this program and I've been trying to use it and replace all of the stuff I used to do with Photoshop and Bridge, which I had older versions of Photoshop. I've never used the Creative Cloud version of Adobe stuff. I really am not a fan of software as a service, even though a lot of my work in the past has been in software development. Not a fan of doing that stuff. I would rather buy a program and then decide later on, okay, I want the stuff in the new version. I'll pay that amount. And it's not like a continuous year by year thing. In this case, I can use this one for as long as I feel like, or if a new feature comes out that I want. And other than that, it's a relatively nice program from the ones that I tried. It seems kind of slow, a little laggy, which I hope they improve in future versions. That's really my main gripe, is that some situations it just feels a little slow to use. But other than that, it has a lot of the functionality that I wanted, and that's why I decided on this one instead of any other program that I had tried when I was looking for a replacement. So that was a look at the Acdsee Photo Studio Ultimate 2018 program. Hope you enjoyed this video. Scott from Photography Banzai, thanks. If you enjoyed this video, please consider subscribing. Helps me out a lot. Likes and shares help out a lot as well. Thanks again.